My next guest is Catherine Hennessy, the CEO of icap, or Immigrant, Counselling and Psychotherapy. icap is a specialist British-based service supporting people from Irish and other communities facing emotional issues such as depression, anxiety, stress and the effects of childhood trauma. They aim to improve mental health. This is a distressing time for many, and it's good to know that there's an organisation in tune with our particular culture and customs on standby. They can be contacted at 020-7272-7906 and have a comprehensive website, icap.org.uk. I'm pleased to welcome Catherine Hennessy. Catherine, a very good afternoon.
Thanks, Sherry. Good to be here.
Right, Catherine, before we look at detail of the work of icap, it would be good to learn more about yourself. Where are you from, and have you been in the UK long?
I'm from County Offaly, a town called near Kilcormac in County Offaly, and I've been in London since 1987. Listeners might remember that was the week I arrived, the week of the King's Cross fire, the tragic fire at King's Cross station. So I've been here for quite a number of years now.
Indeed. Now, can you give us an overview of your professional background?
Sure, yeah. I trained originally as a nurse at St. James's Hospital in Dublin, and then came to England and worked at Great Ormond Street Hospital. And since then, I've worked in a variety of charities, including with people with mental health problems. I've retrained as a social worker, and I've worked with people in the criminal justice system, people who are sleeping on the streets, a good number of whom, sadly, were from Ireland as well. And then I've been at icap since 2013.
Right. Now, it's all equipped you well for your role currently. I'm aware you have a network of therapists and clinical centres in Finsbury Park, London, and Digbeth, Birmingham, currently closed, of course, due to COVID-19. What is your range of services, and how are you delivering them at this difficult time?
Okay, so we closed our centres, Jerry, on the 16th of March, just before St. Patrick's Day, in response to the COVID pandemic. But although our centres are closed, we continue to offer therapy. And most people are continuing to have therapy, often by telephone, because we can offer therapy as well by Zoom or by video call. But many of the people that we would be working with would potentially be older or wouldn't have access to that sort of equipment, so we can speak to them on the telephone. In response to the COVID pandemic itself, we've set up a helpline, partly in recognition of the fact that it's a very stressful time for us all, really. None of us, no matter how old we are, we've never dealt with anything like this before. And it can be stressful, people at home together a lot of the time during lockdown, potential for arguments to arise. It's very stressful for us all. You know, we're worried about the future, maybe worried about our jobs, worried about money, perhaps losing friends or relatives and not being able to attend their funerals, or not being able to get back to Ireland to attend family funerals. And that's been something that people have been calling us about. So it's really anything that people want to, they can ring us. Our helpline is available 5 days a week, and they can call us on 0207-272-7906. And they'll be speaking with somebody who's a trained therapist, and somebody as well who will understand where they come from and their own cultural background, really.
Now, Catherine, having spoken to many outreach organisations since March, there's room for optimism. I'm told first-time users of smart devices have mastered the technology, and many organisations see that as a benefit going forward. Not a substitute for face-to-face meetings, but something that can run alongside. What's your view?
I agree. I mean, I think there are a number of people whom we work with, certainly, that we were very surprised with the speed with which they got on board with the technology, sometimes faster than some of our own staff. So I think it's a great thing. But I think for many people, what they miss is the face-to-face contact with other people. You know, if they go to places like London Irish Centre or Birmingham Irish Association, it's not just about talking to the staff. It's about meeting friends that perhaps they've known for decades, that they meet there on a regular basis. So I think there is still a lot of benefit to be derived from face-to-face meeting. However, in the circumstances that we find ourselves in, I think it's a good way for people to stay in touch with each other. And I'm reading and hearing about people who are using the apps online to access Mass, whether it's in the UK or in their home parish. So I think there's a lot of positives as well.
Indeed. Now, there are parallels between the ICAP niche and the aims we have here at Irish Radio. We increased output to daily shows at the daily live shows, indeed, at the start of lockdown to combat loneliness, taking requests to connect listeners and the community. Now, we're mindful that permanent closures of Irish hubs, such as social and community centres, also pubs, traditional meeting places, led to isolation or due to suspended services because of COVID, such as coffee mornings or lunch clubs where people gathered. This is further compounded. Now, it's important people are aware that ICAP operates for those feeling vulnerable.
Indeed, yeah, and sometimes it can be just somebody who wants to have a chat. Somebody, a woman phoned not long ago whose husband had recently passed away, and she just wanted to have a chat with somebody outside the family about some of the things that were going on. For others, it can be maybe that there's been quite a long-standing issue, something from childhood that they've never spoken about, some difficulty, and being indoors has maybe focused their minds on it in a way they wouldn't necessarily have wanted, so they might welcome the chance to talk to somebody about that. And our therapists are there to listen to people and to hear what and to help in any way that we can.
Indeed. Now, for some services similar to your own, people may need a referral, but there could be a waiting list or the expense may be a barrier. So how easily can people access ICAP services, and is there a cost?
For the helpline service, there is absolutely no cost. It's absolutely free. Anybody can phone up and can, you know, refer themselves. Just all we ask people to say is give us a name and a telephone number. And that's purely so that we can call you back, because sometimes people don't want to use up their own credit on their own phone calling us. So we will phone you back. For the therapy, there can be a small charge, but that's very income dependent. So for people who are on pensions or on benefits, that would be very low. Say maybe £1 or £2 per week. So it's designed to be accessible to everyone in the community, really.
That's very, very encouraging. Now, in these exceptionally challenging times, the resources you offer must be in high demand.
They are, and we have got quite a number of people using our services at the moment, which is why I'm encouraging people to use the helpline in the first instance, because then if people need psychotherapy or therapy or counselling, they can be referred on to that from the helpline. It's not an either-or situation. People can use both services at the same time.
Okay. Now, Catherine, you rely on funding in brighter times. Members of our team have been along to your popular quiz nights. Very enjoyable, and the entry fees give a source of income into the bargain. Now, these initiatives aren't possible just now, but Tara Cronin from your team got in touch to ask if we could spread the word about hashtag Power of 10 campaign, which is your summer appeal and challenge. And our listeners can click on to the banner on our website, irishradio.org, for details. Like all the very best ideas, it's a simple one. Give us the lowdown.
Okay, so in ordinary years, as you say, Jerry, we would have had a summer social. We'd be looking forward now to an event in the autumn. But as you'll be aware, those things are not possible. And 2/3 of the people who use our service are either unemployed or retired or on low income. So they would be making a very small contribution. And obviously, therapy costs more than that to provide. So to help us fill the gap, we had an appeal over the summer, which is still ongoing, where people can either do a challenge. It might be post up 10 pictures on Facebook, or it might be walk 10 miles, or some of the more athletic in the community. A couple of our supporters ran 10 miles a day for 10 days. Now, I'm not suggesting that people would be up for doing that, but just anything, or just going directly to our website and making a donation. You don't have to do any activity, but if you do want to do an activity, then we'd encourage that as well, and we'd encourage you to send us pictures either through our Facebook page or on our Instagram account.
Excellent. It's a sort of a win-win situation to do something fun and then donating via the button on your website, icap.org.uk. That's the website. Now, there's lots of inspiration there too, as to how people can get involved responding to your challenge to us to look after ourselves during the pandemic by doing something to help our well-being. Participants are setting exercise goals, posting inspirational quotes, or uplifting photos and sharing recipes on social media. Now, if you've any time in your hands during your busy schedule to kick back and relax, what do you like doing yourself?
Well, I like walking. I'm a big walker. In fact, my own part of the challenge was to walk across London. I walked from Greenwich in the east to in the southeast to Richmond, which was quite about 26 miles, I think. So
Wow. That
was quite a step. I don't usually go that far, but I find myself that I like reading as well. I'm not averse to a bit of television, listening to the radio, and also, I guess, talking with friends and family, because I think, like many people, I've really missed that contact over the lockdown. So it's nice to now be able to see people, even if in a limited way, and just talk to people, because I think for those of us who like going out, a friend of mine said to me, I've been a bit like, she said she'd been a bit like a half wound clock since the lockdown because she'd not been able to see anyone. And I think there can be a lot of us feeling a bit lonely or feeling a bit out of sorts. So it's good to get out and see people.
Yeah, excellent.
If we can, in a safe way, obviously.
Indeed so, indeed so. Excellent stuff. Well done on the walk, wow. Now, back to the more serious side, we'd urge people to get behind the Power of 10 Challenge, and I'm delighted to see online that the target actually has been exceeded. However, the world having changed a lot in a short space of time, people feel worried or concerned about their welfare or that of their family and friends surrounding illness or job loss or maybe arranging a funeral without the usual social gathering. Isolating is to some people. Keeping the fundraising going to ensure services are maintained is vital. Catherine, I'm sure you'd appreciate receiving whatever people can afford.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for this opportunity to talk about the service. And yes, we would very much value any financial support that people can offer. We would be very grateful via our website or via your website and the banner on there. So thank you very much, Jerry.
A real pleasure, Catherine. Now, to summarise, ICAP are committed to providing therapy for people experiencing emotional difficulties who ordinarily find it hard to access help, perhaps due to being in a low income or disadvantaged because of discrimination. 2019 statistics revealed that they helped about 200 people weekly, 75% were out of work, 50 therapists formed the team, and collaborate with partner organisations. Catherine, what's your estimate as to the increase in inquiries because of COVID-related issues?
I think we've had a significant increase. I mean, obviously, we had a bit of a lull during the tight lockdown, if you want. But in the last week, I would say we've had at least a 40 to 50% increase, last few weeks, rather, a 40 to 50% increase on the number of people who would normally be approaching us.
Right, now we live in more enlightened times than previously when mental illness was often a taboo subject. However, I'm sure it's still worth people being reassured that your service is entirely confidential.
It is, that's correct, Jerry. Yes, everything is confidential. And also, you know, it's between you as the person who comes to use the service and the therapist. And I think what a lot of people value is somebody who understands where they're coming from, both geographically and emotionally. I know somebody phoned up last week and was talking to one of our therapists and said she was going to be offering it all up for the Holy Souls. And I think she really valued the fact the therapist understood that reference, knew what she was talking about. And I think that's really important. And it needn't be anything serious. Sometimes it's just something that's burrowing away inside that's maybe bothering you that you want to talk about that people can phone up. Mental illness is a very big word. And I think we're really talking here about people who maybe are struggling emotionally or finding it difficult to cope, as many of us are in these difficult times.
Indeed, Catherine, thank you very much for confirming that and giving an informative insight into the excellent scope of ICAP. Now, once again, the telephone number is 020-7272-7906. That's 020-7272-7906. The website is icap.org.uk. A link to the Power of 10 fundraising site is on our website, irishradio.org. If you or anyone you know would like help from ICAP or indeed can donate to the Summer Appeal, please share that this insight interview with their CEO Catherine Hennessy will be available to listen after today's show on our YouTube channel. You can search Irish Radio with Jerry Byrne on YouTube. It could be important to someone feeling vulnerable. Catherine, thank you very much for taking time out of your busy schedule to outline your commendable work on the work of ICAP.
Thank you very much, Jerry, and thanks for all that you're doing. I'm sure people are really appreciating having the radio is a wonderful companion for people who are lonely. So thank you for all that you're doing too.